感谢赞美主，今天早晨看到一群这是充满了活力的神的军队在这里。
Praise the Lord, this morning we see a mighty army filled with energy here.
不论是年长的、年幼、年轻的，大家在赞美的时候是全心的投入。
Doesn't matter your age, I see everyone worship God enthusiasm.
我也看见这一群，你们是一群大有信心的上帝的子民。
I also see you are a group of God's children full of part of God's faith.
因为在你们在这里经过了十几年的岁月，凭着信心每一天靠着主的恩典向前迈进。
Because for past 16 years, you are here every day, you, by faith, you live by faith.
我相信当初开始的时候，你们没有看到这个愿景吧。
I'm sure at the beginning you didn't see this picture.
我相信很多人会说不可能，我们不会达到那样的境况。
I'm sure many people will say this is impossible, we cannot get to this stage.
但是我仍然相信在我们当中一定有一群人坚持靠着主的信心来走这条道路。
Well, I'm sure there's a few people that continue to have this faith and walk by it.
以至于我们可以建造这样的一个美好的圣殿。
That's why we can build this beautiful sanctuary.
让许多人可以进来。
So many people can come in.
在你们身上就已经显出这信心的功课。
We always see the result of your faith.
信心是进入应许的一把钥匙。
Faith is the key to get into the promise.
开启通往丰盛的门。
Open the door to abundance.
假如我们不明白，我们没有这样的信心，我们就看不见我们生命的应许丰富。
So if we don't have this faith, we cannot see the promise of abundance in our life.
我听过一个故事这样讲。
One story said this.
有一个人去钻油。
One person go to drill oil.
他钻了好几年。
He keep on drilling for a few years.
好像快要到了，快要到了。
Almost, it feels like almost there, almost there.
他最后一个底层。是一个很硬的一个岩石。
But very bottom is a very hard rock.
他不管怎么样的去做
，No matter how he did drill，
总是看不到油上来。
He couldn't see the oil come out.
他就整个人就失望、绝望着就离开了这个地方。
So he left with despair and disappointment.
过了没多久，另外一个来钻油的人来了。
Not long after, a person who drilled oil came.
他只在那个位置的旁边一点点，不到多远的距离。
He just drilled right next to it, not too far.
然后就一钻，油就出来了。
And he drilled, the oil came out.
他就觉得他这么幸运啊。
He felt, wow, he was so lucky.
人家钻了那么多年，
the person drilled so many years,
一无所得。
He couldn't gain anything.
我钻了，哇，怎么这么幸运就有了？
I was just drilled and so lucky, I got it.
不是那个人，他钻不到。
Not just because the other person he couldn't get it.
而是他的坚持，他的信心没有办法维持到下面。
Because he lacked the endurance, perseverance.
在我们的信仰生命也是一样。
The same for our spiritual life.
最难的也是信心的功课。
Most difficult part is our faith.
因为时时刻刻我们会受到各样的挑战。
Because constantly we are challenged by all kinds of challenges.
无论是教会的施工。
Maybe it's a church ministry.
团契里面，家庭里面
or problem from fellowship of your home.
或者是个人的健康
or your personal health.
个人的事业
or personal career.
你家庭的生活关系
your relationship, your family.
我们每一天都要靠着主的信心，能够胜过一切的患难。
Every day we need to depend on God's faith to overcome all this.
所以我用几点来跟大家一起分享。
So I want to show you with a visual few things.
透过希伯来书第十一章第一节
，From the Hebrew chapter one, chapter 11, verse 1,
我们都很熟悉这段经文。
We all know about this.
信，我们一起说来，信是所望之事的实底
，the assurance of what you hope for，
是未见之事的确
，is assurance of what you expect。
信心是所望之事的确据
，faith is assurance of what you expect，
未见之事的。
Also, it's assured what you want to see.
事情要发生了。
There's something going to happen.
我们还没有看到。
We haven't seen it yet.
但是我们有信心。
But we have faith.
美好的事会临到。
The beautiful thing going to arrive.
我用简单的方式跟大家分享。
I'll show you with simple way.
第一件
First,
信心是一种看见。
Faith is a seeing.
是一种眼光。
It's an eye seeing.
这个信心若是从神那里来的。
The faith is from God.
无论环境怎么样的考验我们。
If that's from God, from no matter what your circumstances is.
无论各样的事物来缠绕，来拦阻我们。
No matter what happened,
我们凭着神所赐的信心，我们可以越过。
From the faith of God, we can overcome it.
我们从圣经的人物里面，我们都可以看到这样的人。
In the Bible, we see many examples.
我们以亚伯拉罕为我们的例子。
How about Abraham?
我们称他为什么？
We call him the father of faith of the father.
当他还没有成为信心之父之前，
When he had become the father of faith yet,
他的情况是怎么样？
What does he do?
他对他的将来一无所知。
He knows nothing about his future.
上帝就呼召他从他的家乡走出来。
So God called him from his hometown and get out.
往那个旷野去。
So walk to the wilderness.
方向在哪里？
Where's the direction?
目的地在哪里？
Where's the destiny?
我为什么要离开我的家乡？
Why he need to leave his home?
他完全不知道。
He has no idea.
但是神呼召他出来。
But God called him out.
他凭着信心。
By faith.
每天跟着神的引导。
Every day he followed God's guidance.
神今天带领他到这个平原，他就在这里居住。
When God led him to this place, he lived there.
神带领他到那个高山，他就在那个高山居住。
Another mountain living God, then he lived there.
神跟他立约。
God has a covenant with him.
只要你相信我。
As long as you believe me.
我要使你成为众国之父。
I'm going to make you a father of all nations.
我要使你的后裔像天上的星、海边的沙一样。
Your descendants will be as many as the star or the sand of the shore.
对每一个人来说都是梦啊。
For everyone, this is a dream.
因为这是凭一句话说的。
Because just by one word.
如果是一个人告诉你。
If this is what word from the person.
你在等待你的孩子一个，可能已经多年没有生小孩。
Maybe you've been trying to have the baby for many years.
你等待了多年。
You've been waiting for many years.
很多人为你祷告。
Many people pray for you.
也许有人说，啊，再慢慢等，一定有的。
Maybe people say, just keep waiting, you will have.
是我们怎么样能够有确信呢？
So how can we have this assurance?
除非是神自己来做印证。
Unless God has assurance for us.
让我们经历不管多少的难处。
So no matter what difficulty we face.
我们会看见。
We can see.
我们所信的应许会成就。
The promise we believe was going to be fulfilled.
亚伯拉罕也是如此。
Same for Abraham.
在旷野漂泊那么多年。
He was wandering in the wilderness for many years.
上帝说你要成为众国之父。
God said you're going to be the father of all nations.
他连自己的儿子都还没看到了。
And yet even he has no son.
而且他年纪也渐渐长了。
And he's getting older.
他的太太也过了这个生育的年纪
了。And his wife also cannot have given birth.
每一件事神说的都是不可能。
Everything God said is impossible.
好像每一件事都是不可信的。
Something that everything is unbelievable.
可是神说，只要你顺从我。
But God said, as long as you follow.
用我的眼光来看要发生的事。
Use my view to see the world.
你观看天上的星。
You look at the stars in the sky.
你观看海边的沙。
You look at the sand on the beach.
这些数字会成就的。
All this number going to be fulfilled.
你说不可能啊。
Or you say it's impossible.
我的事情太大了。
That is the thing is too big.
我的问题太大了。
My problem is too big.
但是神说，只要你相信我。
But God said, as long as you believe in me.
我带你到哪里，你就到哪里。
You just follow me.
他也有高山，也有低谷。
No matter it's mountain or valley.
他也遇到试炼，他也有害怕恐惧的时候。
No matter the trial or fear.
甚至上帝在他的身上做一个没有人能够承担的考验。
And yet also God make an impossible test on him.
在神应许了他得到了他的唯一独爱的爱子。
God promising God a beloved only son Isaac.
神说把他还给我。
God said, return it to him to me.
给我。
Give it back to me.
我爱他
I love him.
我要他
I want him.
你把他当作活祭献给我
So offer him as a sacrifice to me.
我相信对很多人都很难啊。
I'm sure this is very difficult for us.
我在读神学院的时候
，When I was in seminary,
我的老师问我
，My teacher asked me,
你为什么要来读神学院
？Why you want to study in the seminary?
你的父亲不是牧师吗
？Your father is pastor.
很多父亲那个牧师的父亲都不愿意让孩子来念神学院。
A lot of pastors they don't want their kids to go to seminary.
希望孩子。不要像他那么苦啊
！They don't want their kids like let them live so painful.
承担那么大的责任
，so carry so many burden.
承受许多人的舆论
，a lot of criticism from other people.
很多时候要承担的超过别人能够承担的事
，and maybe this is beyond our we can bear.
甚至自己在那边沉重的哭泣的时候，也不能告诉别人
，and even maybe you're crying, you cannot share all this to other people.
所以。我的父亲，他也是这样告诉我。
My father told me the same thing.
如果不需要的话，你不用到神学院去。
If not necessary, don't go to seminary.
你可以去选择当医生。
I can be a doctor.
你可以当军人。
I can be a soldier.
你可以当公务人员。
I can be a government employee.
你可以在你的身份里面可以荣耀神。
You can do all the kind of thing and still glorify God.
就是不要做牧师。
Just don't be a pastor.
但是神拣选人不一样，是不是
？But God, the way is different.
当神的感动临到
，When God's calling on us,
我就跟我的父亲说，我要去念神学院。
So I told my father, said I want to go to seminary.
他那时候心里有点挣扎。
He had some struggle in his heart.
因为在那个之前，我本来要去投考军校了。
Because before that, originally I planned to go to the military school.
因为在那一年正好我要投考是那一年是。蒋介石总统过世那年
，because that year was President Chiang Kai-shek passed away.
突然间在那一年有几万几千个年轻人报考军校。
Suddenly that year has many many people want to go to military school.
后来我父亲跟我说一句话。
At the end, my father told me one thing.
你要当地上的军人还是天上的军人
？You want to be the soldier of heaven or soldier on earth?
Amen.我选择了当神的军人。
I chose to be God's army.
Amen. 凭着信心
，by faith，
看见神的引导和带领。
You see God's guidance in your life.
第二个我们要思想的是
，second，
信心是一种行为，也是一种行动。
Faith is action, also a behavior.
怎么样能够看见你的信心？是借着你的生活和你面对事情的时候那种的表现。
So in your life, how can you reflect your faith?
当我们遇见患难来临的时候，我们可以想尽办法要用人的方式去解决。
When the difficulty comes, we can try a lot of way by our own strength.
等到我们找不到答案，我们解决不了的时候，我们才说：“主啊，你来参与吧。”
Only until we try our own way and no help, and there's a God, now your turn.
但是很多时候，我们却在那里抱怨神没有参与。
But many times we complain that God didn't involve in our life.
但是圣经里面有一个人物，我好喜欢他。
But I love one person in the Bible very well.
就是大卫王。
It's King David.
他在年轻的时候被父亲差派去探望他的哥哥。
When he was young, his father sent him to visit his brothers.
一到那里，原来他哥哥他们在面对一个极大的一个羞辱和挑战。
When he was there, he saw that their brothers they're facing a big insult and big challenge.
然后他就很生气。
And he was so angry.
这个人为什么可以这样随便乱骂、咒骂你上帝的名，也咒骂上帝的百姓
？Why this person can say such an insult way to our God's army and God's children?
应该要有人去把他解决啊。
Must someone to get rid of him?
然后又转身过来说：“你们这群人，军人。”怎么搞的？没有一个人敢上去啊
！And he turned around and said, "Why does nobody one of you willing to go?"
不是他的哥哥们的问题
，It's not his brother's problem.
连他们的王都说，谁能够抵挡他呀
？Because even the king said, "Nobody can defeat the person."
当大家在那里怀疑的时候
，As everyone is doubting,
大卫说：“我去。”
David said, "I'll go."
我去。
I'll go.
我要解决这个人。
I'll scare of this person.
每个人都担心了，你是个小童哎。
But everyone said, "Oh, you're just a child. You're just a small shepherd boy."
你拿什么去跟他征战
？What are you going to bring it to fight?
他随便就可以把你打碎了。
He can just defeat you easily.
所以他周围的人每一个人都想用人的方法去帮助他。
Everybody surrounded him just want to use people's way to solve.
国王说：“你用我的头盔，你用我的盔甲，你用我的剑。”你去征战。
So King Saul said, "I'll give you all my armor. You go."
人的事、人的想法、人的言语，有时候成为我们的绊脚石。
So and sometimes the people's mind and way, all these things actually hinder us.
他只有凭着信心。
He went by faith.
不单单是相信。
Not only believe.
他走出去。
He walked forward.
他抛弃了所有人的给他赋予的保护。
He get rid of all the protection from other people.
他抛弃每一个人说的任何负面的话。
He get rid of everybody's negative thing.
他只有一个心。
He has only one heart.
万军之耶和华可以胜过这一切。
Almighty God can defeat him.
Amen.
Amen.
他靠着万军之耶和华，靠什么来击败
？How he defeat by through
Almighty? 上帝的大能啊
！It's power of God.
我们常常说是，是靠那颗小石头吧
？Everything, just because the small stone.
是靠大卫的技巧吧
？Or the skill of David?
是靠环境吧
？Or by our environment?
甚至有的圣经学家说，是因为那个大巨人他是近视啊。
Or some people say the Goliath because he have near sight.
他看不见大卫在哪里
，He cannot see where's David.
露出了他的破绽。
So that's his weakness.
好像是这些条件吗
？Maybe because of that？
不是
，No。
你也许只有小小的一颗小石子在你的手上
，Maybe you only have a small little stone。
也许你只不过是一个小牧人
，Maybe just a small little boy。
但是你是奉主的名出去征战
，But you go out by the
你宣告，你面对这么大的巨人。你说万军之耶和华必帮助我，我必打胜你。
He proclaimed that Almighty God must be help me, so I'm going to win.
我必胜过这一切。
I'm going to overcome all this.
就在那一刻
，at that moment，
他就打胜了。
He won.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，Dear brothers and sisters，
我们生命里面也有许多的巨人。
In our life, there are also many giants.
其实巨人也有很多弱点的。
There's also a lot of weakness in the giants.
只是我们比他显得更软弱。
Because not only just because we show we are weaker than them.
我们就害怕去面对去征战。
Then we are afraid to face the giants.
神是我们的帮助。
God is our help.
神是我们的膀臂。
God is our arm.
他教导我们，我们的手可以拉弓，可以征战。
He teaches us to know how to operate all these weapons.
我们可以行在高处。
We can walk in a high place.
可以行得更远。
We can walk even further.
信心是要有行为的。
Faith need to have action.
信心是要用行动来活出来的。
Faith need to live out by actions.
Amen.
Amen.
你手中的工具可以成为你的利器。
Our tool in our life can become a weapon.
最后一点
Third,
信心是一种生命
Faith is life.
是顺从上帝的旨意与他的带领的生命
It's to follow God's guidance.
我相信每一个人生命神都有预备一个蓝图
I'm sure in everybody's life God has a blueprint there.
只有你在回头过来看说哎，我怎么在那个阶段会这样到了那个阶段怎么会这样
Only you look back and can say, oh, what happened back then?
因为早就神就为我们预备了
Because God has prepared all this far in advance.
因为从圣经的记载里面我们看到有几处的地方神在带领以色列人建造无论是方舟无论是会幕无论是圣殿
In the Bible, we see no matter when God's people built the ark, tabernacle, or temple.
当挪亚来到上帝的面前，神吩咐他说：“你去造一艘方舟。”
When God asked Noah to build an ark,
挪亚没有说：“啊，好，好了，照我的想法去造。”
Noah didn't say, "Okay, then I'll use my own idea."
没有
，No.
神说：“我有一个蓝图。”
But God said, "I have a blueprint."
你要怎么造？
How are you going to build it?
长宽高。
The dimension,
房间几间要怎么做？我早就想好了。
I already had this idea.
你就照我的话去做。
You just follow my way.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
们就看见这个世界毁坏了，但是挪亚一家人和动物都存活了。
But you see this world perished, but Noah's family and animals survived. 神
展现的蓝图是带着拯救的能力。
God's blueprint is with power to the intention to save.
神吩咐摩西建造会幕的时候也是如此。
Same thing when God asked Moses to build tabernacle.
神告诉他什么样的木，什么样的帐，什么东西要放在哪里，要打造什么样的材。
The detail, a blueprint, a tabernacle, what the inside is furniture set up.
只要你跟百姓说我要这些材料。
As long as you tell the Israel, say I need all this material.
神早已预备。
God has prepared far advance.
所以当摩西跟众人讲以后，每个人都感动，他们就把他们所有的金银财宝都捐出来了。
So when Moses asked people, everybody to chip in to donate all what they have.
多到什么程度？多到上帝说不用了，不要太多了。
They bring as many as even God said, stop, we have enough.
神早有预备。
So God has prepared.
Amen.
Amen.
我们也看见所罗门要建圣殿的时候，神虽然没有让他的父亲建造，但是在他的心里面，他顺从了这个意思。
So same thing when God asked Solomon to build temple.
他来到神的面前说，我的父亲有这样的意念，他们要建成，我愿意来完成。
So King Solomon said, I want to fulfill my father King David's will to finish building the temple.
我们看见所罗门建造了一个极荣美的一个圣殿。
So Solomon built a glorious temple.
所有的人都可以聚集在那里领受。
So everyone can get together to worship.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，
Dear brothers and sisters,
这是在旧约时代的建造。
This is the building in the Old Testament time.
今天神也在我们当中建造。
So today God also wants to building us.
建造他所要居住的圣殿。
Building the temple, the sanctuary he wanted to dwell in.
在哥林多前书三章那里说。
In the first Corinthians chapter 3 said.
神要在我们身上建造。
God wanted to build something on us.
已经把这个根基立在基督耶稣的身上面。
He already laid the foundation on Jesus Christ.
除了耶稣基督以外，没有别的根基了。
Except Jesus Christ, there's no other foundation.
那你要用什么样的材料来建造？
Then what type of material are you going to build?
有人用金银宝石。
Some people use gold, silver, and diamond.
也有人用草木和楔子。
Some people just use wood, just wood cheap material.
同样建造。
The same way they built.
但是在经过火炼的时候。
But after the burn of the fire.
有多少能够存留下来？
But what going to left?
亲爱的弟兄姐妹。
Dear brothers and sisters.
让我们时时刻刻在上帝的面前。
May us always.
我们要过一个信心的生命。
Always before God we live a life.
神建造神的殿。
We're going to build God's temple.
我们要用什么样的方式？
How are we going to build it?
我们要用读经祷告顺服他的心意。
We're going to use by reading the Bible, prayer, and follow His commandment.
因为圣经里面告诉我们说，
Because Bible said,
我们每一个人的身子就是圣灵的殿。
Our body is the temple of God.
圣灵是从上帝而来，住在我们里头。
The Holy Spirit came from God, the world in us.
并且叫我们不再是自己的人。
So we no longer belong to ourselves.
因为我们是重价买来的。
Because we are redeemed by the big price.
我们每一个都是被重价买来的。
We are redeemed by a heavy price.
为的要在我们身上显出神的荣耀。
So in order in us to show the glory of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
当我们愿意这样行出来生命的时候，
when we
神的荣耀就被彰显。
When we willing to live this way, then God's glory is going to be revealed.
愿上帝赐福我们每人。
May God bless everybody.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
在我们当中，如果你信心软弱
，Among us, if you have a little faith,
你失去了对主的依靠
，You lost the trust in the Lord.
你遇到患难
，You're in the difficulties.
你遇到挫折
，You're in the discouragement.
你盼望能够重新站起来
，You wish you can rise up again.
今天早上我可以邀请你
，This morning I'm going to invite you.
你愿意的话，你举起手来
，If you're willing, you raise a hand.
你有什么样的忧虑？
All your worries.
你有什么样的烦恼？
All your trouble.
你举起手来，我为你祷告。
You raise your hand. I'm going to pray for you.
我们凭信心向主宣告。
By faith, pray to God.
他是创始成终的神。
He is God from beginning to the end.
他的是信实的神。
He is a faithful God.
在他没有难成的事。
In Him, there's nothing is impossible.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
亲爱的主啊，我们感谢赞美你。
Dear God, we thank you, praise you.
今天早晨你就临在在我们中间。
This morning you are among us.
你的荣光像云彩一样围绕在我们这里。
Your glory just like the clouds surrounding here.
你要使我们重新与你面对面。
You want to use us face to face with you again.
让我们能够重新与你建立美好的关系。
So we can again be rebuild a new relationship.
在我们当中有许多软弱的身体。
Among us, there's very weak.
心灵忧伤的。
We are suffering.
有事情缠绕的
We are worried by many things.
有各样的忧虑在我们身上
All kind of worry in us.
主啊我们都把他们带到你面前
Lord, we bring it all to you.
我们献在你面前
And we offer it to you.
愿主你的圣火来焚烧
May you use the holy fire to burn it.
焚烧一切捆绑我们的
Burn all this have bondage on us.
焚烧一切挫折我们的事
Oh, burn this, all this that discourage us.
赐给我们健康的身体
Give us a healthy body.
赐给我们强壮的灵命
Give us a strong spiritual life
每一天过着信心的生活
Every day we live by faith
走在信心的道路上面
Walk in the road of faith
一直直到见你的面
Until we see you again
奉耶稣的名祷告
In the name of Jesus we pray
Amen
Amen